Good afternoon, everyone. By the authority given in the statutes of the Open University, I declare this congregation open for the conferment of degrees and the presentation of graduates. Distinguished guests, graduates, and friends of the university, it's my great privilege to welcome you all to the 26th of the Open University's degree ceremonies being held this year. Last year, the Open University awarded an astonishing over 25,500 qualifications. These ranged from Certificate of Higher Education to Doctor of Philosophy. Throughout this year, more than 8,000 graduates like yourselves will be presented for their qualifications. The ceremonies are being held in 10 different towns and cities throughout England, and also in Belfast, Cardiff, and Dublin. And all that goes to illustrate the extraordinary scale and scope and reach of our university. We're delighted to welcome heads of educational bodies and councils on the platform, representatives of Scottish health boards and of the Scottish government, also principals of other Scottish universities and colleges, and members of the Scottish Parliament, as well as Open University honorary graduates. It's my great pleasure to welcome Mr. Roland Stiven, who is here today to accept the award of Doctor of the University on behalf of his late mother, Dr. Tessa Ransford, and to welcome our other honorary graduate, Tommy Whitelaw. We're delighted to be able to honor them both today. Now, I hope it goes without saying that today is a hugely important occasion in the life of all of you, our graduates, as well as your families and loved ones here to support you. And of course, the university staff, who I'm sure you'll feel have supported you along the way. But given the grand venue that we're in, the wonderful music, you might be forgiven for thinking that the occasion today was going to be serious and solemn. But you'd be quite wrong. In every sense, this, I hope, will be an afternoon of celebration. So I think we're all going to be disappointed if any of our wonderful graduates crosses the stage today to anything less than tumultuous applause, or whatever other way you choose to express your enthusiasm and support. And you may have seen a few little clues in the video that was shown earlier. So I think we should have a little trial, don't you? With that in mind, can I ask our graduates to stand? And friends, families, and OU staff, let's start by giving them all a wonderful round of applause. Please stand. Thank you. That was pretty good. I mean, this morning was noisy, but you're even better. I can hear you've been warming up all day. So when that moment arrives and your special graduate steps forward, just feel free to clap and cheer as loudly as you like. And if you want to stand up so you can see better as your graduate walks across the stage, please feel free to do so. And it's particularly nice for graduates who are parents to be able to spot their children in the audience. So maybe we should have a practice of that now. Are there any children in the hall? Are there any children in the hall? Okay, good. So please stand up and wave to your mum and dad so everyone knows where they are. Good, good. Get those sight lines. And we have known some families be a little bit competitive about how well they cheer for their mums and dads. So if you feel like that, please go for it. And there's one more way, slightly quieter, that you can show your appreciation of your graduate. Lots of people like to post on social media these days, so if you've got photographs or messages that you want to send for your loved one who's had this fantastic success, if you post it with the hashtag OU_ceremonies, that's OU_ceremonies, then all of those posts will be available and people can see how the Open University is celebrating the wonderful achievements of its new graduates. So lots of ways to get involved. Today's ceremony will begin with that posthumous awarding of the honorary degree of Doctor of the University to Dr. Tessa Ransford. And Ms. Susan Stewart, who's our Director of the Open University in Scotland, will read the citation, and then Dr. Ransford's son, Mr. Stiven, will sign the honorary graduate's book next to me and then make a reply on behalf of his late mother. Following this, we'll have the first presentation of graduates who've gained so-called higher degrees, and they will be presented by Dr. Martha Cadell, who's the Deputy Director of Learning, Teaching and Curriculum of the Open University in Scotland. We'll then see the awarding of the honorary degree of Doctor of the University to Tommy Whitelaw. Professor Jan Draper, who's head of our School of Health, Wellbeing and Social Care, will present Mr. Whitelaw. And then we'll continue with the main presentation of graduates with those who've gained first degrees. Lucy MacLeod, Deputy Director of Students in the Open University in Scotland, will present those first degree graduates. It's also Lucy's last ceremony officiating here, and I want to thank her for everything that she's done for the Open University in Scotland. And then to conclude the ceremony, I'll give a personal address to the graduates. I now call upon Ms. Stewart to read Dr. Ransford's citation.
Vice-Chancellor, colleagues, brand new OU graduates, guests and friends. Tessa Ransford was one of the outstanding poets of her generation and a leading voice championing the vital role of poetry in contemporary society. Tessa was born in India, but her family returned to Scotland when she was 10. She went to school in St Andrews and then read philosophy at Edinburgh University. She joined the Society of Friends and for more than a decade did missionary work with the Quakers in Pakistan while raising her children, Meg, Hilda, Roland, and subsequently Jeannie. Back in Edinburgh in the 1970s, Tessa worked at the Netherbow Arts Centre by day while writing poetry in the evening. Tessa had always been an avid reader and writer of poetry since her teenage years. In the mid-1970s, her work began to be published, first in Scottish International, and then in several well-received collections. Over more than 40 years, and in 22 publications, she produced a rich body of work, engaging intellectually and emotionally with themes of identity, spirituality, environmental and political activism, and Scotland's past, present, and future. Tessa was also deeply interested in the creative potential of collaboration and translation. With the Syrian-Palestinian poet Ayat Hayatli, she published Rug of a Thousand Colors, work inspired by the five pillars of Islam, with each translating the other's work. Her final collection was published in 2015, entitled A Good Cause, the cause being poetry itself. Tessa was also a thoughtful and respected critic, reviewer, and essayist. Beyond her individual work, Tessa made an extraordinary contribution to cultural and artistic life in Scotland. Finding a lack of mentors herself, critics and champions of poetry, in 1981 she founded the School of Poets to be a supportive and thoughtful environment for poets to discuss their work and develop their voice. The school continues to this day, nurturing and encouraging successive generations of poets. Her next project was even more ambitious, a permanent centre for poetry in Scotland to collect and celebrate published works, to develop public interest in poetry, and to promote and encourage the spoken word and poetic performance. The result was the Scottish Poetry Library, which opened in 1984 with two part-time staff and four shelves of donated books. As director for 15 years, Tessa helped make it the international institution it is today with an exceptional collection of over 30,000 items, wonderful facilities, and an exciting events programme for both children and adults. After retiring from the Scottish Poetry Library, Tessa set up the Callum MacDonald Memorial Fund in memory of her late husband to recognise and reward publishers of poetry pamphlets. For 10 years, she was the editor of the Scottish poetry journal Lines Review. Subsequently, she was a fellow of the Royal Literary Fund based at Queen Margaret University, and she also served as president of the prominent Literary Writers and Editors Association, Pen in Scotland, for 3 years. As head of Pen, she championed freedom of speech and literature across borders. She earned the OBE for her work at the Scottish Poetry Library. Sadly, Tessa passed away in 2015. Her work and achievements reflect the ethos of the Open University in bringing poetry to the wider community and inspiring learning. She leaves not only behind an extraordinary individual writing legacy, but also a wider artistic and cultural legacy, securing poetry a central place in Scottish national life. Vice-Chancellor, by the authority of the Senate, I present to you for the honorary degree of Doctor of the University on behalf of Tessa Ransford, her son, Roland Steven.
Thank you, Susan, and thank you, Vice-Chancellor. Tessa was particularly honored to receive this award for two reasons. Firstly, for the citation, which recognized both her work as a poet and her wider work for poetry in Scotland. But the other reason was simply that it came from the Open University, which is an organization that embodies the ideas of democratic intellect and social justice, both of which were woven together in Tessa's life and work. Tessa herself graduated from Edinburgh University in the 1950s with what was known as a general arts degree. And for Tessa, this covered subjects as diverse as geology and moral philosophy and German literature. But university was a personal and intellectual liberation for her after years of austere post-war schooling. And this intellectual freedom was something she valued highly and worked hard to share with others. Tessa would have liked a bit more life, a wee bit more time, to share ideas with students of the Open University. However, poets leave behind many of their best ideas, well-crafted and neatly encapsulated as poems. So, here's a very short one. It's quite apt in this time of iPads and laptops and online courses. And it's titled, "The Book Rediscovered in the Future." And it goes like this. One day in the future, a child may come across a book and say, "Imagine being able to hold in your hand what you read, carry it with you, wear it out with your life, pass it on bearing your marks, your name written in ink, your signature, your wavelength in letters." I hope that those of you graduating today and getting to put letters after your names find you can inscribe those letters with your own wavelength. I wish you all the best of luck. Thank you.
Vice-Chancellor, I shall now present graduates who have gained higher degrees and have been able to attend here today. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, I present to you for a thesis entitled "The Evolution of Methane in the Subsurface and Atmosphere of Mars," Adam Stevens. and for a thesis entitled The Role of the Vascular Endothelial Growth Factor C, Vascular Endothelial Growth Factor Receptor 3 in Colorectal Cancer Development and Progression, Carlotta Tacconi. I present to you for the degree of Master of Arts in Childhood and Youth, Naomi Skelton. And Claire Young. For the degree of Master of Arts in Classical Studies, I present Louise Harrop. For the degree of Master of Arts in English, I present Paola Ippoliti. For the degree of Master of Business Administration, I present Roberta D'Amore. Michael Fitzhenry. Ian McCabe. Alexandra Titan Snyder. For the degree of Master of Business Administration, Technology Management, I present Sophie Wells. For the degree of Master of Education, I present William Brown. David McGee. And Paul Trickett. For the degree of Master of Engineering, I present James Inman. And Neil Murray. For the degree of Master of Laws, I present Elizabeth MacLeod. For the degree of Master of Science in Development Management, I present Cynthia Zielstra Adriano. For the degree of Master of Science in Environmental Decision Making, I present Christina Reinards. For the degree of Master of Science in Environmental Management, I present Lorna Pilbin. For the degree of Master of Science in Networks and Distributed Systems, I present Alex Waslin. And for the degree of Master of Science in Software Development, I present Raymond McRae.
Colleagues, graduates and guests. Tommy Whitelaw is one of the UK's most effective and influential campaigners for people with dementia and their families. For many years, Tommy had a successful career in the music industry, where he worked with the likes of Kylie Minogue, the Spice Girls and U2 in merchandising operations. But in 2007, his mother Joan was diagnosed with vascular dementia, and he gave up work in order to care for her. Despite his heartfelt love for Joan, Tommy found the day-to-day experience of care incredibly difficult. And understandably, it was a dark and difficult time, and Tommy became increasingly lonely and isolated as he battled against the complexities of the health and social care system. Tommy believed there had to be a better way, and he set out to make a difference for the thousands of carers like himself. He started a blog and a campaign, not to raise money, but to raise awareness among professionals, politicians, and wider society. In 2011, he walked across Scotland, collecting the stories of other carers. These stories are deeply moving in their selflessness, generosity and compassion. They're also testimony to the many unnecessary struggles that drain carers of the time and energy which would be better focused on their loved ones. In 2014, he presented many of these stories directly to the First Minister, Nicola Sturgeon. And as a result, many members of the Scottish Parliament made personal pledges to tackle the problems associated with dementia care, from the invisibility of family members to the lack of support in rural areas, to training for student nurses and the specific needs of veterans. Tommy is now a project engagement lead at the Health and Social Care Alliance's Dementia Care Voices project, where he uses these stories to help professionals focus on the people, not the disease. For the past 2 years, he's also been on a Make a Difference tour, speaking to over 50,000 people in person and collecting more than 10,000 personal pledges to make a difference. This started in Scotland, and his work and his fame has extended across England in both the NHS and voluntary sectors. The Open University has developed several modules which help students to understand the particular issues that dementia presents. And drawing on Tommy's insights, we hope we have opened our students' eyes to the experience of caring for someone with dementia. Today, there are more than 850,000 people living with dementia. That's one in 14 people over the age of 65. And as our population ages, it's predicted that numbers affected will rise to more than 1 million in the next 10 years and 2 million by 2051. Or to put it another way, we will all know somebody affected by dementia. And many of us will need to grapple directly with the emotional and practical issues involved. Each of us, therefore, has a vested interest in ensuring that people living with dementia and their families are treated with the respect and dignity that they deserve. Tommy's work is helping to make that a reality. It's an honour to thank him on behalf of all our students who've benefited from his work, to acknowledge his commitment to this vital cause, and of course, to remember his beloved mother Joan. Vice Chancellor, by the authority of the Senate, I present to you for the honorary degree of Master of the University, Tommy Whitelaw.
With great thanks to the Vice-Chancellor, members of the Senate, graduates and guests, I'd planned to write something down, but I've kind of changed it again. I made a promise to my mum that I would always speak from my heart. So I want to say a quick couple of thank yous first to spread it out. I'm really honoured today to have my Chief Executive Ian Welsh here today and my colleague Laura, who are giving me a chance to keep continuing a campaign that I started as a son and from a bedroom, and to have my cousins here today. I would love my mum to be here today. I'm wearing this tie today, and my dad gave me this tie when he was very, very poorly. And he said, I want you just to wear that tie when it feels really special. This is a tie I wore on the night I fell in love with your mother. And today feels a really special day to be in a room full of such dedicated and incredible people who are dedicating their lives to learn, to thrive, and inspire, and to help people in our communities. I'm really proud that this work's allowed to continue with Ian and the Health and Social Care Alliance and my mentor and friend Irene, who couldn't be here today. The Alliance does incredible work with the Self-Management Programme in Scotland, the Links Worker Project, and our own Dementia Care of Voices project. And it's all based on taking a time to listen to what matters to people and individuals and basing everything around that. And as graduates and lecturers and vice chancellors, no matter what your role is across the Open University or as a graduate today at the university, you have the potential and the opportunity to transform the lives and the experiences of the people that you will work beside, you will live beside, and many of you will care beside. I mean, what an incredible gift to have that something in your heart told you one day, I'm going to apply to the Open University. I'm going to go and learn. I'm going to absorb all that knowledge, and I'm going to use it to help people and help give opportunities to others. But that gift that this room is absolutely full of today, I think, becomes the most beautiful gift of all when you hand it over to the people that you will work beside and you will live beside and you will care beside. I also want to thank the incredible Joyce is here today, who's been an absolute, helped me believe in myself in many times. So I just want to thank you for this great opportunity. Somebody asked me a few weeks ago, what did I learn about dementia, caring for my mum living with dementia? And it's that people are brilliant, and they're remarkable, and they're incredible. And if you just take a little chance to listen to their stories and help them along the way, you'll find out how incredible and beautiful and remarkable they are. So thank you to every one of you and graduates today for being beautiful, for being remarkable, and being incredible. I'm a very proud son today. Thank you.
Vice-Chancellor, we now come to the part of today's ceremony that marks the presentation of graduates who have gained a first degree and have been able to attend here today. The full subject and classification details are printed in the Directory of Graduates. I present to you for the degree of Bachelor of Arts with First Class Honours, Philippa Brebner. Sally Buckley. Emma Calder. Kirsten Craig. John Grant. Pamela Hasty. Steve Housen. Daniel Jackson. Christine Lawrenson. Lynn McCausland. Louise McCoubrey. Sarah Napier. Angela O'Sullivan. Betty Ramsey. Lynn Riley. Vivianne Scott. Alison Thomas. Paul Thompson. And Andrew Wagstaff. For the degree of Bachelor of Arts with Honours, I present Brian Adams. Halima Ahmed. Gemma Alexander. Linda Anderson. Gail Annan. Heather Bain. Elizabeth Barclay. Fabio Bechtold. Marion Black. Patricia Bradley. Hanneke Bremer. Pauline Brown. Fiona Bruce. Susanna Burt. Gumni Butler. Kate Byrne. Diane Cable. Sarah Cairns. Gail Carlin. Helen Chandler. Ian Shane. Anna Marie Clemenson. Fiona Cowan. Joyce Cowie. Helen Crichton. Jerry Crombie. Cara Cruikshank Ryan. Sharon Diel. Tanya Durick. Peter Drinkwater. Caroline Dundas. Jessica Egers Hardy. Christopher Etock. Nicole Edwards. Sarah Elliott. Jennifer Ellis. Linda Empson. Amanda Evans Nash. Gillian Fairbairn. Catherine Farah. Kimberly Foster. Hallie Fraser. Moira Gargan. Kirsty Gordon. Emma Grant. Kerry Grist. Jonathan Hall. Angela Hancock. Sarah Higgins. Elaine Hurst. Nancy Huari Evangelista. Marion Hughes. Sheila Humphreys. Alison Huntington. Judith Hutchings. Catriona Hutchinson. Fiona Jeffrey. John Kelly. Elaine Cannell. Tanya Larkin. Michelle Legg. Alina McCaskill Simpson. Callum MacDonald. Ginny MacDonald. Jean Mackay. Ruth McIntosh. Kathleen McLean. Joe Megan. Holisady McGuire. Joshua Malcolm. Ashley Manson. Robert Mapletoft. Elaine McClelland. Scott McIntyre. Alistair McLaughlin. Gillian McMillan. Jilly Milroy. Jodie Mitchell. Lorna Mooney. Caroline Morgan. Paul Morgan. Tina Naman. Dorothy O'Rourke. Denise Oldham. Jacqueline Perez. Fiona Pocock. Lisa Prodom. Karen Ramage. Diane Riley. Kevin Rickus. Annabelle Rotmistrovsky. Johanna Scott Moncrief. Gillian Shanks. Cherie Shaw. Samantha Smith. Jeffrey Steedman. Lorraine Steele. Kenneth Summerford. Margaret Summers. Fiona Taylor. Alexander Trainer. Helen Veer. Ingrid Vevers. Gareth Walker. Helen Watson. Jane Watson. Weir. Grant White. And Scott Zuckert. For the degree of Bachelor of Arts, I present Charlotte Brownlee. Leslie Ann Doherty. Emma Littlejohn. Tracy Lloyd. Linda Megson. Louise Pedden. And Margaret Walker. For the degree of Bachelor of Engineering with First Class Honours and Bachelor of Arts with Honours, I present Gwendolyn Newton. For the degree of Bachelor of Engineering with Honours, I present Jeff Manson. David Nelson. And Dennis Trodden. For the degree of Bachelor of Laws with First Class Honours, I present Fiona Barnes. Hurst. For the degree of Bachelor of Laws with Honours, I present Nicola Bartlett. Elizabeth Hardman. Emma O'Connor. And Lisa Stones. For the degree of Bachelor of Science with First Class Honours, I present Annie Bradshaw. Jane Chandler. Mandy Clark. Peter Cullen. Robin Faulkner. Lisa Ford. Carly Fox. Ian Gillan. Douglas Harris. Luke Harold. Emily Isatt. Brian Loudon. Noreen Malia. Anne Steele. And Alan Taylor. For the degree of Bachelor of Science with Honours, I present Carlene Afonso. Leslie Allen. Shona Berenson. Kenna Ballion. Risto Bergman. Mary Louise Blake. Ruth Bland. Abigail Burgess. Audrey Birdley. Henry Campbell. Emma Carmichael. Graham Carmichael. Jamie Christmas. Oliver Cliff. Alison Cole. Lindsay Cooper. Kirsty Darlington. Claire Dawson. Jack Deere. Peter Douglas. Andrew Duthie. Gwen Farmer. Lisa Gardner. Holly Graham. Raisa Hapala. Denise Halliday. Gillian Harvey. Victoria Heen. Camilla Heron. Ben Hewlett. Amy Holden. Lorraine Johnson. Sadia Khan. Elaine LaRoche. Leanne Lawrence. Claire Logue. Claire Logue, sorry. Ian McKee. Anne McGowan. Michelle McQuillan. Sandra Mitchell. Derek Newlands. Zoe Newsom. Paul Orr. Anthony Parker. Emma Parker. Tom Patterson. Karen Pryor. Bella Raposa. Dorothy Robbie. Laura Rogan. Gillian Rose. Bridget Sadler. Mohammed Sapi. Jamie Sharp. Aileen Smith. Alice Smith. Fiona Stewart. Taylor. Lana Taylor. Jean Thompson. Linda Trickett. Esme Walker. Daniel Webb. Emily Wildig. Williams. Mandy Wilson. Janet Yorkshades. And Michal Zitko. For the degree of Bachelor of Science, I present Nicola Cameron. Carol Davey. Helen Foster. Andrew Gale. Vivienne Gilly. Sarah McFadden. Carolyn Prentice. Dean Stevenson. Margaret Strain. Sarah Taylor. And Heather Wilson. And for the Diploma of Higher Education, I present Julie Bapti. Leanne Henderson. and James Lermont.
Very loud, Usher Hall. Congratulations, that was brilliant. Good afternoon, everyone. Guests, members of Senate and staff, and of course, our wonderful newly graduated graduates. It's been a special day for everyone here, I'm sure, one to remember for the rest of your lives. And I had the privilege of some beautiful short conversations with people, telling me about the jobs that they were going to go on to, how the learning with the Open University had inspired them. I asked people how their studies were. Into two camps, really. Enjoyable, fun. Others were a look of terror came across their face. And I realized that I'd helped them to have a flashback to a particular TMA or something like that, and we swiftly moved on. Apologies for that. No, but seriously, some fantastic stories and some absolutely inspiring people who I had the chance to meet very briefly. One person who told me about how studying with the OU had literally change that person's life by enabling that person to be able to come out of the home, to be able to do things that that person wasn't able to do before, and it literally changed the life of that individual. That's the kind of thing that study with the OU does. Inspiring. I know that everyone here is extraordinary, but together you're clearly even more extraordinary. In fact, I believe you're the most amazing body of graduates, certainly anywhere in the UK. All of you and your friends and supporters are probably sharing this hall with the most amazing people you're ever likely to meet. Now, for your family and your friends, they know the incredible efforts that you went to in achieving your qualification. But many of you won't know other graduates and won't know that much about each other, because Open University students don't always come together in large groups. So I'd like to just take a few minutes so we can all show each other how extraordinary you are as a group. I'm just going to ask a few questions and ask graduates to put up their hands if you don't mind. So first of all, who was employed or did voluntary work at some stage during their study? Pretty much everyone, I would say, almost everyone. Who helped to bring up a family during their studies? So working and family, because there's quite a lot of people who got both. And then who cared for parents or other dependents during their study? So almost everyone as an OU graduate has had an extra obligation, or two, or three, alongside their study. Now please compare that with conventional universities and ordinary students. Their extra duties might only extend, say, to the sports bar, to the sports team, or to their dedication to the sports bar. Your efforts are much greater. You are members of a university that believes where you start in life shouldn't limit where you go. Now, occasionally I have a small frustration about the description that's given to students like you. You're often described as part-time students, whereas conventional students are full-time. OU students, part-time. It's certainly like double time or triple time when you're with the OU. You've been on a really tough shift. But there's only one thing tougher than being an OU student. Yep, it's living with an OU student. And many of you, as you came across the stage today, said, it's my dad, it's my granddad, it's my kids. You all know, as graduates, how much you owe to your family and your supporters. So I think it's probably worth taking a moment for all of the graduates to acknowledge the support of your family and friends. They've been by your side every step of the way. So graduates, please look round and locate your family and supporters, and please give them an enormous round of applause as well. And whilst we've got the graduates applauding, as another group, I hope you'll agree, that should be celebrated as well. That's the Open University's wonderful academics, represented by my colleagues here on the platform. They wrote and presented your courses, and crucially, were the wonderful tutors who taught you and helped get you through. I hope you'll agree too, that they're deserving of enormous appreciation. So you're all special, but you're also special because the quality of the university that you've just graduated from and the standards that we set, standards that we know that employers in particular greatly value. We know that 30,000 businesses and organisations in the UK have chosen the OU to train their staff, and a recent survey showed how those employers regard part-time students to be hard-working, committed and disciplined. And they recognise the importance of supporting their employees when they have study aspirations. So your OU qualification is something to be really proud of. It's really well recognised and respected. So I hope that if you're someone who is looking for a new job or a promotion following your qualification, please remind your employer of that. And here are a few other facts that you might want to pass on to someone who might be employing you, or indeed anyone else, about the university of which you're now a graduate. 3 years ago, the Open University led the way in innovation, in digital innovation, when we set up the UK's first platform for free, massive open online courses. That's the platform called FutureLearn. Since it's been set up, an extraordinary 5 million learners have signed up to it around the world. We're doing wonderful work with people who need our help the most. The Open University is working with the British Council to deliver academic programmes to displaced refugees in Syria. I'd like to turn to another really important part of the Open University, its research. When the last exercise which assesses university research in the UK was carried out, it was discovered that 3/4 of our research was marked as being either world-leading or internationally excellent, a huge achievement. And this research can often capture the public imagination. For instance, we're incredibly proud of our contribution to recent space exploration, including our involvement in the comet-chasing Rosetta mission. More recently, we were involved in the Mars orbiter and lander, and the orbiter is still going around Mars and bringing back research information which we're studying. And over the summer, we were part of the team which analyzed a little wobble in space, which helped to discover a new planet which was orbiting our nearest star. It looks like that planet may have the right conditions to support life, which would make it one of the most extraordinary scientific discoveries of all time. So I hope you can see from those few facts that you are a member of a university that's world-leading in technology and in innovation and in helping people to learn. And now you will always be a member of this university, what we call our movement of millions, and a mission of one. You're also joining a community of OU alumni all around the world. The OU has been by your side throughout your studies. Now we could give a commitment to you to stay with you on your lifelong learning journey. Our motto on our crest is learn and live. That's something that all Open University graduates now embody as you step out back into your busy lives. You've proven you've got great skills and ability. Be confident that you can change the world around you for the better. You're part of a vast network of people as extraordinary as you are. So make your voice heard. Join up with other OU alumni, for instance, on our LinkedIn Alumni Careers group, or try some of our free online courses on OpenLearn or FutureLearn. And some of you the gluttons for punishment who are coming across the stage told me that you're already doing some new OU study. And for those of you who are feeling that you need a little bit of a pause, maybe you'll come back to us before too long and continue your OU studies again. Members of our alumni team are outside, and they'd love to talk to you about what our Alumni Association can offer, as well as ways that you can possibly give back to your university through our new Open Up the Future campaign. Because when you leave today, we hope that you'll become an ambassador for the OU and all that we stand for, our values of social justice, equality, and knowledge for all. So please share your experience with others. Tell people what your OU journey has meant to you and what it could then mean for them. I hope you've seen our wonderful TV and cinema adverts that bring to life the jubilation and sometimes the trials of being an OU student. But we know that for potential new students, a word of recommendation from a graduate or from an OU student is far better than any commercial. You are our best possible advert. The proceedings of this degree ceremony have been completed. I'm so sorry. There's one last thing that I wanted to do. I think we shouldn't leave the graduates without giving them one further round of applause. So let's please join together and give one last congratulations. Sorry, I was rushing on there because there's a treat coming which I wanted to tell you about. The proceedings of this degree ceremony have been completed, and I now declare this meeting of congregation closed. The piper will now provide us with a musical farewell, at the end of which I'd ask all of those who are able to stand to please do so.